Director of Athletics at Holy Cross, Mr. Nathan Pine joins us. Thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to speak about Crusader sports.
Kevin, my pleasure. Glad to have the opportunity to talk with you and with our fan base.
First question for you. We're standing in a new environment here in the Hart Center. What has you most excited about what's been happening this season on campus?
You know, for us here at Holy Cross, it's been probably a year of unprecedented change in the athletic department. I've been on campus now for 9 months, and we've begun to assemble a staff, put people into place, and really working hard on the external side to get our name back out in the community and start to engage our fans and alums in ways that we haven't for a while. So I'm excited about that. We've brought in some folks with a lot of athletic experience and a wealth of knowledge from some from big schools, small schools, but really seen athletics done in a number of ways on a number of campuses. Folks from the University of Maryland, from Miami, from Louisville, from Drake, from Cal Berkeley, people that come into our department, again, with a lot of ideas, a lot of enthusiasm, and I think that's starting to become contagious around our athletic department, and hopefully giving our fans and our folks a taste of what athletics can be at Holy Cross. With that, we've taken initiatives to grow a lot of our rebranding campaign around campus that we introduced this summer. We've made many physical changes to our facilities, which I think will help us in the long run. I've talked with our coaches, I've talked with our student athletes and folks around campus. They notice what's going on. They feel that change and excitement, and hopefully I think it'll set us up for success long into the future. This is just a foundational piece and a start, but I think it's a very important one.
Nathan, the fall sports season just wrapped up. What team stood out to you this year?
You know, I think there were a number of teams that had a lot of success this fall, and we're starting to build on where I'd like to see us go. But women's soccer stands out to me. They had their most wins since 2000. Allie Spencer was Patriot League Rookie of the Year. She led the conference in scoring with 25 points. So I think there are a lot of good days ahead for our women's soccer program, and that excites me. Volleyball tied for their most wins in a season in Patriot League history. So even better days are ahead for that program as well. On the cross-country side, junior Dennis Muldoon placed ninth at the National Catholic Championship. It was the best finish for a Holy Cross runner in the last 20 years, so very exciting there. On the women's cross-country side, freshman Hannah Jeter was named a Patriot League Rookie of the Year, and she was also selected first-team All-Patriot League, so very good things happening in our cross-country program this fall. And hopefully we can continue some of this momentum and winning tradition into our winter sports, which have already kicked off on campus.
What types of physical changes will people see if they come out to campus this winter for a hockey or a basketball game?
Well, I think if you drop by our facilities, you'll notice an increased awareness around our branding. Some of those new logos and new initiatives I talked about us unveiling in the summer are starting now to manifest themselves in our facilities. We're making a conscious effort in the branding so that when people tune in on the Patriot League Network or come into the facility, they get a real sense of what Holy Cross is and who we are athletically. If you walk through the hallways of our hockey and basketball facility right here behind me, you'll see images that incorporate not only our past and our storied history of athletics, but also some of our new student athletes that are competing for the purple and white today. So I think the fans that are coming and seeing it for the first time will be surprised, hopefully encouraged. We've got a lot of feedback. Our student athletes love what we've done, getting good feedback from our coaches on the recruiting trail that when they bring folks to Holy Cross and into this facility, there's a real sense of what a Division I program this is and an excitement around it that we haven't had in a while. So over time, I think it'll have a big impact on our program.
Men's basketball won its first game against a ranked opponent since 1977, beating Harvard to open the season. Have you noticed a different buzz around campus this year?
Well, Kevin, I'll tell you, that's a good way to start the season, isn't it? Yeah. It gets people excited and energized. So yeah, we definitely have noticed a lot more smiles on our players' faces, certainly a lot more conversation around the water cooler and the lunch table. People are taking notice of the caliber of team that we have this year. And it's important to get off to a hot start. We, you know, had a great game against Harvard in the Garden in front of a nice big audience on a television game. And then we came back and backed it up against Brown with a nice win at home in front of a big crowd. So, yeah, there is some excitement building around this program, and I think we've got an opportunity to have a pretty good season. Got to get lucky, got to stay healthy. There's a lot of things that go into it, but always nice to get off to a fast start, and I'm excited for Coach Brown and the guys.
On the same note, the hockey program is under new guidance with head coach David Berard. Have you noticed a difference this season with him at the helm?
Coach Berard stepped in and he's had an immediate positive impact on our program. Currently, we sit in second place in Atlantic Hockey, so we've gotten off to a fast start there as well. Been very happy with that. It certainly helps with enthusiasm around what's going on with the buy-in from the team. But Coach Berard stepped in on day one and talked about culture and having a family atmosphere around our program and also having an upbeat, fast-paced of play, which I think our players enjoy and have really bought into. That, in addition to having two strong senior captains that really set an example on the ice, has helped our team gel early on under Coach Berard's leadership. So I'm pleased with that. Now, if we can stay healthy, we can catch a break here or there, we might have a chance of having a special season.
Nathan Pine, thank you so much for speaking with us today about the Crusaders.
Kevin, it's my pleasure. Always good to sit down and chat. Nice to be able to talk about some of the new initiatives and things that are going on around campus and really to keep our fans and alums in tune and engaged to what's going on, the great things that are happening with our student athletes and some of the new initiatives that we're trying to roll out and make this athletic department a little more exciting. So thank you very much.